Departure of Sage Suka. Maharshi Suka addressed King Parikshit. O King Parikshit, I have narrated to you the sacred Bhagavata, a Mahapurana, as learnt by me from my revered father. The Bhagavatam has mentioned several times the praise of Lord Srihari, the controller of the universe. He was several times worshipped and praised by Brahma, Rudra and several other gods. You have heard all this with rapt attention and immense devotion. Now, therefore, you had better cast aside the feeling that I will die. It is an animal conception. The body was born at one time and it perishes at another time. You are not born, you will never die. You are other than the body. When a pot is broken, the pot space is not broken. So also, when the body dies, the soul does not lie. It becomes one with the Supreme Brahman. Maintain a constant thought of Lord Vasudeva, investigate the truth about the self and merge in him. On account of the Brahmin's curse, Takshaka may bite your body. He cannot touch the soul inside it. Even death cannot touch you. Feel, I am Brahman, the Supreme. Identify yourself with the Supreme and realize your true nature. You will be a witness for the serpent biting your body. Thus have I narrated the stories of Lord Srihari, O Parikshit, at your request, to you who are no other than my own self. King Parikshit prostrated to Sage Suka and said, O Sage, out of your grace I have heard the great Bhagavata Purana from you. Now I am not afraid of Takshaka or death. I have entered the fearless state, the blissful state of oneness with Brahman, as instructed by you. I shall now control my senses, speech and mind and leave the body. My ignorance is destroyed by firm knowledge of truth, jnana and vijnana, its realization. Hearing these sweet words and obtaining respectful leave from King Parikshit, Sage Suka with all the other sages and saints left the place. Parikshit alone sat on the banks of Ganges, controlling the breaths and facing north. Takshaka, as per the curse of the Brahmin boy, was coming on the way. He met a Brahmin, Kashyapa, who was capable of neutralizing all kinds of poisons. Takshaka doubted his powers. As an experiment, Takshaka bit a big banyan tree and it was burnt to ashes in no time. Kashyapa brought the tree back to its original state, including the birds, etc., that were living on it at that time, and also a man sitting on one of its branches. Takshaka accepted the greatness of the Brahmin, gave him large presents, and requested him not to come near the king where he was going. Takshaka approached Parikshit in the guise of a Brahmin and offered a lime fruit to him, hiding himself inside the fruit as a tiny worm. As soon as Parikshit pressed the lime to his eyes as a mark of reverence, Takshaka resumed his real form of a snake and bit the king. The body of Parikshit was burnt to ashes in a moment. There was a great hue and cry, while the gods showered rain of flowers and made great applause. King Janamejaya, son of Parikshit, hearing of the father's death by the bite of a snake, started a snake sacrifice wherein snakes were offered to fire by Brahmins. Takshaka, afraid of his life, sought protection of Indra and tried to escape. When the king tried to offer Takshaka along with Indra into the fire, Brihaspati, the preceptor of the gods, warded off further snake sacrifice by advising the king to stop such destruction of living creatures. The king gratefully accepted to abide by the advice of Brihaspati and stopped the snake sacrifice.